Everybody, hello puppies, hello into our welcome to our messy yard. We're on the north side of the house, and so we have all kinds of snow and ice. Yes, this is Ghirardelli. Hi Ghirardelli. This giant Great Dane is Nikita, and of course Uffda there, and the little black one is Shadow. And Uffda is just doing an amazing job of hanging out with his new friends, and his favorite game ever is to play fetch. Ready? Where are you? Ready? Yes, here we go. Go get it, buddy. Go, go, go. Now, of course, it's winter time, and so we haven't cleaned the backyard a lot, and it's a little poopy, a little messy. But look how good this boy is. And he brings the ball back and he drops it for me. And then we're gonna go play some more. Go, Uffda. Oh, we were in different directions. Find it, find it. Good boy. Uffda is as deaf as could be. And so I talked to him just because I talked to all the dogs. And why would I not talk to him? We're working on hand signals. And so he's learning how to sit. And he's learning how to stay. That is the hardest one. For him to stay is nearly impossible. We lost that tennis ball, didn't we? Good thing I have an extra one. Hi. Yes, you ready? Go get it. Whoops. We're gonna lose that one too. Oh, that one went through the fence, buddy. Sorry. Turn around. Let's get your sight on me. Good boy. Good boy. I'm so sorry it went through the fence. Yes. There we go. That's all in midair. That's a catch. Yes. Good boy. Hi. Thank you. There's probably 10 tennis balls in this yard, but a bunch of them are buried under the snow. So we bring one or two out fresh every day or every couple days. And we just play and play and play. And when he starts to get tired, because we did this for an hour before I went in and got the camera, he holds on to that ball a little longer. And he doesn't let me have it as quickly. Oh, we're going to need a bigger yard for this boy, I think. Hi. It's a pretty big yard, but still. Yes. Hi. I hope the video's coming out. Are you ready? Yes, you're so handsome, little boy. Tomorrow, Uffda goes to the vet to get a checkup. We're gonna have his noogies taken off. It's time for him to get spayed because every time he comes in the house, he wants desperately to mark his territory. So we're gonna try to tame that down. We also don't want him to produce or reproduce, I should say. We don't need any puppies on this farm unless they're livestock guardian dogs. So all of our rescues, our sanctuary babies, they all get fixed. And we're going to check his ears because he has these scabs in his ears that I want to figure out what's going on. I don't know if he has ear mites or something he's got in there. And they don't seem to feel good. He won't let you touch them. He's also got some bum teeth, so we're going to look at his teeth tomorrow at the vet's office, too. All right, but I sure wanted you to see how much fun he has. When Uffda first came to our sanctuary, he had a lot of dog-on-dog aggression, and he still has some dog-on-cat aggression, but we have taken care of this dog-on-dog aggression. It's really pretty awesome. We, first thing we did was he's been living on a chain for the last 7 years. So we had to put him back on a chain. But we put him in the yard here with everybody else so that he could learn to get along with the pack of dogs and everybody would be safe. And he had his own, he's got his own shelter over there. And it's a doghouse surrounded by straw bales. And he would have fresh water 24/7. And his food And he did really well with that. And boy, it didn't take long. I expected it to maybe take a couple months of working with him and the other dogs. And the dogs taught him how to be a dog, Ghirardelli, and how to be part of a pack, a member of a pack of dogs. And he has gotten to where he gets along really well. He no longer wants to kill anybody. He doesn't get that super focused, I want to eat you attitude, at least with any of the dogs. He's always been really good with people. He's just the sweetest dog. He's just worked out so well, and I'm super pleased that it was only a couple of weeks that we worked. We worked every day, but he would have to stay on the chain. And he's just gotten along with everybody, and now he plays, and it doesn't matter. He meets you at the gate. He wants pets. He loves treats. And like I said, he's learning hand signals. So I gotta say, Uffda is definitely one of our success stories. I'm hoping that we can get with the cats and we'll work on that so he can come in the house sometimes. But for now, he loves being out in the world. I'm super thankful to have him here. He's a good pup.